A Metro man dead after a driver plowed through a storefront.
This happened last night near Wilshire and MacArthur. Shattered glass from windows and bottles litter that business. The driver nowhere to be seen.
News 4's Peyton Yeager live outside that liquor store tonight. And Peyton, we're also finding out that looters showed up last night before police could even get there.
Yeah, and speaking of police, they're giving us little information at this time. They tell me that several people called 911 describing different getaway vehicles, making it very difficult for this investigation. Now, take a look at the building behind me. It's boarded up. The tape is still up, and I did get a chance to speak with one witness today. He tells me he got a clear visual of who is responsible for this man's death.
He still would have been at that liquor store. He still would have been taking care of people until that last second came up, because that was just the kind of person he was.
Eduardo Lopez inside this Metro liquor store when a vehicle hopped the curb and plowed through the front door before driving away. Lopez dying less than 24 hours later.
It looked like somebody had thrown a hand grenade at that door.
Tuesday afternoon, Air Comfort Solutions Chopper 4 first on the destructive scene.
It appears to be a strange hit-and-run accident.
Oklahoma City police say after the crash, Lopez's pulse accelerated, causing him to have a heart attack right there in the store.
It was just one of those things that, like, went from zero to crazy real fast.
Those nearby seen in tears, trying to process what just happened as he was loaded into the ambulance. Medical professionals performing CPR on the way to the hospital. On Wednesday, police try to piece together who was behind the wheel. Tim Carnell works at a business next door. He watched it all unfold.
I saw the truck that had run into it, and it was an elderly couple.
Carnell tells News 4 he only had a few seconds to catch a glimpse before the truck took off.
The lights were gone.
Among the chaos of a man's life hanging in the balance, witnesses spotted another crime happening inside the liquor store before emergency crews could even arrive.
Somebody had actually raided the store before the family could show up.
Making the investigation even more complicated for police, as a once bustling family business is now left boarded up and quiet.
To lose somebody like that, it's honestly heartbreaking.
Lopez's family, they did talk to News 4 today. They didn't want to comment on anything. Police, they hope to have more information for us tomorrow morning. They can tell me that they're possibly looking for a black car. Reporting live on the city's west side, Peyton Yeager, Oklahoma's News 4.